scattered clothing, empty homes, and silence. That's all that's left here in Kashuga, its inhabitants having fled a few days ago. The situation in North Kivu has deteriorated considerably. Entire villages have been deserted, and as the violence spreads, even the camps for the displaced are no longer safe. Fighting has forced thousands of already displaced people to flee once again.
We have mobile clinics which go out and treat the displaced population. What we do is we send a team of doctors or nurses to wherever they've settled. They take care of any patients in need of treatment and they inform the population of when they'll next be back. Obviously, some cases are more serious than others. And then some conditions become serious because they haven't been treated in time, like malaria or respiratory infections. All serious cases are referred to MSF hospitals for treatment.
Médecins Sans Frontières is currently working in three different hospitals in the area, one of them being in Rutshuru, 70 kilometers from the provincial capital Goma. In addition to the constant flow of emergency cases arriving at the hospital, during the month of October there were several sharp rises in the number of war injuries. Working around the clock, our teams treated more than 80 war wounded in 48 hours. Most patients are treated for gunshot injuries, although we're seeing an increasing number of shrapnel wounds.
We get new cases every day, but one that comes to mind is the case of a 16-year-old boy that we saw in Rutshuru Hospital. He was trying to run away. The population had got caught in the middle of the fighting. Some people had managed to get away in time, but that boy didn't. He fled with his younger brother, but as they reached the forest, a bomb exploded right next to him. When we recuperated him in Rutshuru Hospital, we couldn't save his arm. We had to amputate. And so that boy, what's his future? His future is to farm his land. How is he going to manage that with just one arm?
Recently, thousands more were displaced as the rebels advanced on the city of Goma. In this rapidly changing context, MSF teams are trying to follow the displaced in order to provide them with much needed assistance.